Yeah, they're at like 600 something now. Yeah, one of them's a trash bag. My friend was telling me about how one of them shoots cheer dudes from his arms. What's up, everyone? My name is Asad Khan. I'll be your host of this new episode of Time to Football, and I'm just going to take some time to thank you guys because in the past 3 days, I've gotten 8 new subscribers. So the Time to Football revolution is on fire. So I'm going to thank Brock Birchall, Demi Paduri, Anima, Cincy Dalton 14. Who's your favorite team? Football is back, and in this episode, I'm going to talk... We have breaking news that we have to report. Tim Tebow, the Thurston quarterback for the New England Patriots, has been released. Sanders, can we get the graphic up there? It was earlier there. Okay, there we go. As you can see, we got a notification from the NFL mobile app, and we took a screenshot of it, I guess. And it happened earlier Saturday morning. This is breaking news. We will keep you up to date on the progress throughout the show. Football is back this week, so today I'm going to talk about the top 3 games to watch this week, and I'm going to give you an upset pick of mine. First game is the Denver Broncos hosting the Baltimore Ravens. Now, this is a rematch of the divisional game from last year, one of the best playoff games that I've seen in recent memory. The Super Bowl winner is usually the one that hosts the team and plays at home, but due to scheduling conflicts with the Baltimore Orioles, they have to play in Denver. Are you happy now, Elaine Bennis? Your team just screwed tradition. Questions still surround the Baltimore Ravens defense. Are they still contenders after Ray Lewis's retirement and Ed Reed going to the Houston Texans? As for the Denver Broncos, it's going to be exciting to see how Wes Welker can help that already amazing passing attack. Next, we're going to go over to New Orleans and talk about the Saints versus the Falcons. Questions surround the Saints defense. Can Rob Ryan, the new defensive coordinator, turn around one of the worst defenses in NFL history from last year? Will the return of Sean Payton bring the Saints back to an elite status? As for Atlanta, are they the same team as last year, or are they even better with the addition of Steven Jackson? Key point, they're playing in New Orleans, which is a huge upside for the Saints. Now it's time to go over to the West Coast and talk about Green Bay visiting the San Francisco 49ers. Now, in my opinion, I'm not really big on Kaepernick. What? I'm sorry, I just have that feeling. This is another rematch of a divisional game. Can Green Bay get back on track to the level of dominance they were at just 2 years ago?
This is 2 News with breaking news.
There is a bank robbery turned standoff happening right now in Springboro. This is at the Fifth Third Bank at North Main Street.
Again, we're following the story of Tim Tebow, the third-string quarterback of the New England Patriots that was released earlier this morning. Now, again, this is very shocking news, very breaking, very imminent news that we had to interrupt a story on a bank robbery in order to report this. Now it's time for my upset game of the week, Oakland over Indianapolis. I'm just messing with you. It's San Diego over Houston. You almost put the graphic too, Sanders. Mike McCoy, the offensive coordinator of the Denver Broncos last year, is the new head coach of the San Diego Chargers. Can he be the one to revitalize Phillip Rivers as a threat in this league again? Also, you have to ask yourself, can Houston really go 12-4 for the third straight year? Now it's time for a segment called The Wrath of... We're going to talk about how horrible of a quarterback Tony Romo is. Yeah, because I was doing my research, and I looked up his career passer rating, and it's 95.6. Fifth all-time in NFL history. Oh, wait, that's a good thing. Oh, maybe I was looking at his 4,900-yard campaign, or his 7.9 yards per attempt for his entire career, which is sixth all-time. Crap. I know what it is. He doesn't win games. Yeah, his 55-38 record as a starter proves my point. Wait, I just figured it out. He doesn't win big games. He can't finish big games in the fourth quarter. Now, there is some truth to that, but guess who has the highest passer rating in the fourth quarter amongst all active NFL QBs? You got it, Romo. higher than Breeze, Rodgers, Brady, Manning, both of them.
So why do we always say that he sucks?
Because he can't win big games?
There are 10 other players on that field with him that make a huge difference.
The blame for every flaw is put on him because he's the star of that team, no pun intended.
When you have a quarterback with numbers like that, that's hard to find. Winning in the clutch is something that can be fixed. Wanna know why? Because it's a mental thing. You can fix mental things in the NFL. Maybe you already fixed it during the offseason. We'll have to find out Sunday night when he goes against the New York Giants in the season opener. But that's all for this week. I hope you guys have a great time watching football this weekend. I will, because I actually quit my job to watch football on Sundays. Funny thing is, some people actually think I'm joking. Don't forget to like this video, leave a comment, subscribe to this channel. Don't forget to follow me on Twitter at @itsasadkhan. It's football, it's humor, it's everything. Trust me, it's awesome. And remember, this is the place to go for your NFL news, content, entertainment, innuendos, defeat your football pleasure, and I'm here to deliver 10 times better than a fat guy sitting in front of his webcam. I have ambitions of being an NFL broadcaster and/or analyst, telling you too can pursue your passions if you just stay hungry.